The blue coat of silence is real. From justice it surely steals. If the playing field was fair, about other things black youth would care. If this society didn't discriminate, they would get education at a better rate. You want black folks to report crime? But let me ask you what's in your mind. Why would you ask that to do when you follow a different route? God gave me these words in a row. My pen went float, float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. It's not only about when you pull your gun. It's also about how you feel or young. You speak to us with a disrespectful tone. That's not how policing should be done. With equality is how it should be done. God gave me these words in a row. My pen went float, float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote, wrote.
The blue coat of silence,
it's real, it's real. From justice,
the blue coat of silence
surely steals, it steals. You can shame my body, but you won't shame my mind. Shame my mind when it's you.
The blue coat of silence.
It's you that do the crime. Do the crime. It is a crime. Lock it down. But my words will still be around. They'll be on the radio. Practice what you preach. That's the greater. We all have to meet. Have to meet. We all have our tests. It's not always easy to do our best. You have a family. You have a home. It makes it difficult to stand alone. When other officers do wrong, will you atone? Or will you let other families continue to moan? God gave me these words in a row. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote. My pen went float, float. So I wrote, wrote. My pen went flow, flow. So I wrote, wrote, wrote. God gave the boy them words, so he wrote, wrote. His pen went flow, flow. So the boy wrote, wrote. His pen went flow, flow. And he wrote, wrote. His pen went flow, flow. So he wrote, wrote.
I'd like to take a moment to address a couple items. To Brianna and so many we know about and the many we don't know about that weren't featured in the video. Judging by the diversity of the world's population involved in the protest for social justice, your sacrifices were not in vain. Rest in peace. You made the world a better place for the rest of us. To my fellow citizens here in the U.S., those of our white brothers and sisters that are afflicted with the burden of hate. And hate is a burden. That false belief that part of God's creation is greater and more loved than another part of his creation. A domestic terrorism law must be put on the books. One not being there is just another form of white privilege. Those of us that are the target of their hate we'll be forced to arm ourselves to defend ourselves and our families. When Black Wall Street was attacked, the government did not come to our aid. You either learn from history or you're doomed to repeat it. The elephant in the room is why the mouse in the room, Trump, is so popular among many of our white citizens. It's because many want to maintain white privilege. They have yet to come to the realization you can't turn back the hands of time. God has the final say. Many are victims of the manipulation of the divide and conquer practice of the greedy ruling class that point them to the so-called others to hate so they won't see they're the real problem. Black folks aren't responsible for good paying manufacturing jobs leaving the country. Because you're a victim, you want to continue to make us your victim. I got news for you. This cycle's about to be broken. They leave us to foolishly fight over what little of the pie they leave us. There's no true form of democracy or socialism in the world. Proof being all the suffering in the world. The push to maintain white privilege is global. There's only two paths to choose from. The stupid path where much blood will be spilled, or the enlightened path where the people of the world work together to make the world a better place for all of the citizens. A world governed by the people for the people. I can see us someday setting a goal to achieve world peace. Something can only be achieved by no longer accepting the rule of the bad actors. We all know who they are. And when it comes to the use of the term defund the police, words matter. We have to realize once you got somebody down on the mat, you don't let them up. By using that terminology, redirect funds or something else would be more acceptable. You give Trump and the Republicans a talking point and allow them to go back to their old playbook of stirring up hate. And I hope your ego won't get in the way of taking a true look at that. But last but surely not least, to my fellow global citizens, I'd like to say, I need to say, has God got your attention yet? And respect